You're short. You don't measure up.
Come on now. Doesn't matter if I'm tall or short. I don't gotta measure up to people. God still sees me. What's up, Torch Kids? I'm Alex, I'm with Teen Creative, and this is our third week of our series called Measure Up, and we're gonna talk about how Jesus was baptized.
It's so simple, faith like a child. I give you an inch and you take me a mile. I feel the wind rush and the thunder roll. 2 feet on the water, only one way to go. Yeah. I don't gotta be afraid no more, no. Cause I know you're up through the storm. I'm more than just a talker. I'm a
Okay. Who in here wants to have fun? If you want to have fun, I need you to come sit right here. Come sit right here. Right here. I love nap time. Okay. Now I need four volunteers. One, two, three, four. Yeah, come up here. Okay. Who wants to be Jesus? Is that four? One, two, three, four? You're holy? I wouldn't compare yourself to that man. You're going to be Jesus. You're going to be Simon, who's also Peter. You're going to be Andrew, and you're going to be John. Yeah.
You should have booked Andrew for Andrew.
Okay!
You should have booked Andrew for Andrew.
Oh!
Hey, you don't spray Jesus.
Jesus is the living water, okay? Okay. Okay, so, let's begin. John, we're in the river. We're in the Jordan. Now, where's John?
Right here.
Come on, John, you're over here. You're right here. John is standing by the river. I need All both of you over here. Jesus, you stay over there. We see Jesus walking toward him. So Jesus walked toward us. Oh, yeah. Oh, hey, look, John said. Say hey.
Hey, look. Hey, look.
Say to them.
It's hey, look.
Hey, look, John said Jesus. To the people around him. It is the guy who takes away sins. You're a professional at this. Oh, my gosh. He has greater than me or anyone else. He is greater than me or anyone else.
He is greater than me or anyone else.
I know he is.
Can you guess who John is talking about?
Jesus.
Jesus. Right there. He's talking about Jesus. Then John started to tell the people of the experience he had. Say, I saw the Spirit come down from heaven. As a dove.
As a dove.
And stay on Jesus. God told me that I baptize the people with water. There you go.
He said, I baptize the people with water.
Say it more and say it with more power.
God told me I baptize the people with water.
Yes, but Jesus.
But Jesus.
Will baptize.
Will baptize.
With the Holy Spirit.
With the Holy Spirit.
I have seen, and I am here to tell you that this man Jesus.
I've seen, and I'm here to tell you that this man Jesus
is God's chosen one.
Is God's chosen one.
Everyone say, awesome!
Awesome!
The next day, John was walking by the river again with two of his disciples. Come on, we're walking. Look! The Lamb of God, Jesus. John said, not everybody, but it's okay. Everyone pointed at Jesus and said, look! You're doing great. Are you having fun? Yeah, that's all that matters. John's disciples, including Andrew, started following Jesus. Who's Andrew? Oh, hey, Andrew. You're Andrew. Started following Jesus. So all of us start to follow Jesus. The first thing Andrew did was find his brother Simon. Where's Simon? Simon. He found him. And he tells him of the Savior that we've been waiting for our whole life. So tell him how cool Jesus is. No, he's telling you how cool Jesus is. I need you to say, Jesus is awesome. Yeah! Then Andrew brought Simon to Jesus. So now we go to Jesus. Right away, you knew who he was. Listen, we're at the Jordan. It gets a little wet here, okay? And he knew who Jesus was going to be. He changed his name to Peter. So Peter, you were once Simon. Now you are Peter. Jesus does not hit. He turns the other cheek. Read the word. Okay. Everyone chant, Peter, 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 I. And that's how Andrew, Simon Peter, and many others followed Jesus too. And that's just how Andrew, everybody listen to me, and that's just how Andrew brought Simon to Jesus. Much like people do in your lives, your pastors, your teachers, your parents, your grandparents, your aunts, and your uncles. And many people in your life are going to bring Jesus to you. Once you start following Jesus, you can help by bringing them to Jesus. Give a wonderful round of applause. Y'all are dismissed. Okay. Are all the jitterbugs out now?
No.
If your jitterbugs are not out, I need you to stand up. If you're tired, I need you to sit down. Now, everybody with jitterbugs, get it out. Is it out? Is that out? Is it out? It's not out. It's not out. Is that all the jitterbugs? Is that all the jitterbugs? Okay, everybody sit down. That's all the jitterbugs for today. That's all the jitterbugs. Everybody take a moment of shh. And sit down. Sit down. Sit down. Your mama's going to be mad when you come back all wet and you got to go to grandma's after this, okay? Okay? So, everybody look at me and go, shh. Shh. Zip the lips. Everybody, zip it. Twist it. Polka dot it and throw it away. I don't know. Do it. You didn't zip it. Zip it. Lock it. Yeah, zip it, lock it, put it in your pocket. Okay! I'm going to start us. Y'all ready? Jesus, thank you for this day. Thank you for this wonderful time to come together. And I pray that above all, as all the fun and everything that we do, that your word shine brightest through all of it. In Jesus' name, amen. Psalms 48 through 11 says, I desire you to do your will, my God. Your law is within my heart. I proclaim your saving acts in the great assembly. I do not seal my lips, Lord, as you know. I do not hide your righteousness in my heart. I speak of your faithfulness and your saving help. I do not conceal your love and your faithfulness from the great assembly. I do not withhold your mercy from me, Lord. Or do not withhold your mercy from me, Lord. May your love and faithfulness always protect me. So, something that I love about the gospel and something that I love about everything that we do is we're called to get people in, right? To say, hey, this is Jesus, this is the gospel, this is the greatest, most amazing thing you'll ever hear. And how many know when you go to the torch, that's kind of an easy thing to do? Let's be real. What big events do we have happening almost all the time? Name some. Kids serve. What's another one? Paint and pastries. What else do we have? Y'all aren't in Converge yet, but we got water on Sunday morning. Like, come on. Ignite. We have all these amazing things that are able for us to attract people to Jesus. Y'all think we just do Ignite because it's this awesome, wonderful light show? I'm here to tell you it's not. It's to get people in to know the Word of God. And each one of you in this room have an opportunity that's greater than any adult, than anybody else in this world, because you are children. You are not ashamed. You are going to go out and you're going to tell people, because we have things like KidServe. Who's going to KidServe? Say, oh, yeah. Yeah. We have Wednesday nights. We have Sunday mornings, and they're extravagant. They're amazing. I love everything we do. We have Ignite. We have Paint and Pastries. We have all these wonderful things that we do in this kids ministry to show people Jesus. We give so many opportunities for y'all to invite people in here. And it's not to become better friends with you. It's to become better friends with our Father. It's to become better friends with Jesus. So all of you can see these lights all over the room, right? Who invented the light bulb? Thomas Edison is the answer around the room, isn't it? No. Well, Jesus. Now here, I'm not going there today, but Jesus, I'm not going there today, but Jesus did make Thomas Edison, and we are called to be the light of the world. So technically, you're the light of the world, which means you're a light. Yeah, ha ha. Thomas Edison. What if I told you he didn't create the original light bulb? He didn't. This is one of the saddest things you're going to learn, and I'm going to teach it to you right now. I need everybody to be quiet. I had a lot of fun, but I'm trying to dial y'all back in, okay? So, the true inventor of the light bulb is a man named Joseph Swan. I know. We don't really talk about the man Joseph the same way that we do Thomas Edison. Does anybody know why? I'm going to tell you this right now. There you go. Joseph was a man who kept it secret, and he kept it with him, and he was trying to perfect it before he showed it to the world. He was trying to add all these perfect little things to make sure the right amount of oxygen got up. I went on a really nerdy phase this week trying to learn about this light bulb, and I found it actually quite amazing because Joseph was trying to perfect the bulb before he showed it, unlike Thomas Edison. He knew that what he had, even though it wasn't perfect, his ways weren't perfect, but the light bulb was going to change the world. He shared it. Much like many people do in your Christian walk with life. So what happened was Thomas Edison was trying to make sure he knew all the little increment details. He knew everything about the light and he showed it. He didn't need to know everything, in fun fact. He didn't know everything. He couldn't make it last longer than 13 hours. That was the max thing that the light bulb could light at that time. Joseph was over here trying to make the perfect thing, trying to know everything about it. And as he was doing everything, someone else caught up. Someone else showed it first. Because he was over here like many of us do in our Christian lives. We say, I can't invite so-and-so to church because I don't know enough scripture to defend my faith. I don't know enough scripture to go up to him and say, hey, Jesus did this. And he goes, well, I don't believe Jesus did that. And you go, well, I have nothing to defend it with because I don't know. Many people, when I talk to them about sharing the faith, when I talk to them about sharing Jesus, they complicate it. They think they have to know everything about him. They think they have to be a scholar. They think they have to know the scripture word for word and know everything that they know to do. And they're like, I don't know enough about him, so I can't share him. When we learned about that story, and I know it was fun and crazy, and Jesus, all he had to do was walk by. All he had to do was walk by. And Andrew said, Simon Peter, this is him. That's it. You don't have to wait till you have perfect grasp of all of Scripture to share the gospel, because if you do, you're never going to show it to anybody. Even Pastor downstairs is one of the most knowledgeable people I've met in my entire life, and he does not know everything about the Word of God. He knows a lot more than I do, and he can defend the faith 10 times more than I can, but he's still not perfect because the only perfect one is Jesus. So we live in a world where all these things are getting thrown at you. Most of y'all, how many of y'all actually have phones at your age? Just raise your hand. And teenagers, how many of y'all have phones? Say, oh yeah. Fun fact about phones is they're awesome. They keep us connected with everyone around us, but they also give y'all so many bad things in one little phone that I can't even describe it to you. So many terrible things get opened up through a phone. For me, it was a friend at school that showed me all this stuff. I didn't even have a phone. I didn't get one. But mom and dad said, you don't get one because there's stuff on there. And what happened was it didn't even take me getting one. It took a friend to show me stuff. Y'all have an opportunity in where y'all are at right now to invite people to know Jesus when they don't know nothing else. They don't know anything else. They don't even know that Jesus was and is because you haven't told them Jesus was and is because you're taking too much time getting nervous about it, making sure that your thing you're sculpting in your heart is perfect. And I'm here to tell you it will never be perfect because the only perfect one is Jesus. We're called to be like him. And all Jesus did was show God, showed the Father through everything that he did. And in this world, there's so many strongholds taking hold of young people every single day that it makes me sad. I went to a conference this year about, it was for teenagers, it was young adults, and the thing they talked about most was it wasn't what you would think. It wasn't, hallelujah, there's 40,000 people here, let's get crazy. The main thing they talked about were some of the strongholds holding people back because we allowed it to. You in this room, you don't have a stronghold yet. You don't have anything grabbing on you. Your friends at school, odds are they don't have anything that's gripping them and holding them, and they don't know what to do because they're just so overwhelmed by the weight of what's happening in their lives. And y'all have an opportunity to show them Jesus, to show them the love, to show them the grace, to show them the mercy of Jesus before anything else gets a hold of them. So I'm going to be quite frank and honest with y'all today. We're in a new year, and I'm like, God, give me a word. God, give me something. And I feel like he told me to share this with y'all. The thing for me is stretching. And you may go, that's a weird word. No, it's not. God is calling me to stretch and go beyond what I think I can do to share the word of God. In my life, I felt so overwhelmed in these past like 2-3 months because everything's going on. There's always this, there's always that. And I feel like there hasn't been a time for me to just calm down and just get with the Lord. But I've taken that time this past month as we've been doing this fast. I've been getting in my prayer life even more. I've been getting in my word even more. I've been getting in my worship even more with God. And the thing that he keeps telling me is stretch. You're not done. You may think this is a lot, but I have more in store for you than you can even imagine. But all you have to do is stretch. You just have to go with me. Andrew in that story had to take a leap of faith to grab his brother and show him Jesus. He had to stretch out his arm and say, come with me. In this room, I want to know, do y'all have trouble doing that? Because I do. I have trouble if God puts it on my heart to talk to somebody in a random parking lot to do it, but I know he's called me to do it. I know he's called me to stretch and stretch what I think is possible because It's not by my greatness that God can be shown, it's by His. I have none of the power, He has all of it. He has the ability to do things within me that I can't do by myself. And He has, y'all have the exact same opportunity. So what I'm going to pray for now is I want to pray not for you, because I believe many of you in this room know Jesus. I know, let's just do a round of, if raise your hand if you know Jesus is your Lord and Savior. That is amazing. Now what I want to do is I want to open up this altar just for a moment, not for a long time, and I want y'all to pray on behalf of your friends that you know don't know Jesus. Pray on behalf of your brothers, your sisters, your moms, your dads, your aunts, your uncles, your friends at school that you see in the hallway that you know they don't know Jesus like I do. And now I want y'all to pray for you to have the ability to show it to them. To say, hey, this is the gospel and it is perfect. I mess up. You're going to see me do things that I wish I didn't do, and you may know of my past life. I know for me that's one of the hardest things, sharing the gospel, is people bring up what I did, not when I was reborn in Jesus Christ and when everything, He saved me and I stopped doing those things and I was brought into the light because someone was willing to reach out to me. I want y'all to be that people that reach out. So the altars are open and I'm going to pray and I want y'all to pray with me. And most of y'all are already down here, just pray. We're in a church where it's not He only hears me, He hears you too. When I pray, y'all have the opportunity to pray out loud, to pray to Him, because He hears you just as much as He does me. I don't have some ultimate key that unlocks the door. No, Jesus had the key and He unlocked the door for me and you to go and intercede in the throne room with Him. All right, so I'm going to pray and I just encourage y'all to pray. Can y'all do that? Yeah? Okay. Close your eyes and bow your heads and talk with me and just ask Him, say, Jesus, I love You if that's all you got. But Jesus, in this time as we are together, in this time where we're here to worship You, I pray that You take our friends, our family, and everything around us, God, and You let them know the goodness of You. You stretch us to do things beyond what we think we can do. God, whether or not it be in our home lives or in our school lives, Jesus, just take us and stretch us to get those who are lost. Stretch us to those who need You, God, and stretch us beyond what we think we can do for Your kingdom. I thank You for everyone in this room, and I pray if they don't know Jesus, that they accept You in this moment, because they can see it in the room. They can see it on their faces. The jump and the joy, the excitement is what happens when you bring people in. It's what happens when you say, this is God. It is not by my will but Yours that You will save the people of this earth. And I believe it, God. I want to thank You for everyone and everything You've ever done. And I want to thank You for the people that don't know You that will soon know You by the people in this room. In Jesus' name, amen. So I think now we have huddle groups. Y'all excited? Go to your huddle.